It's been over 3 years since the Grenfell Tower tragedy. Rightly, steps have been taken to try to prevent something like that ever happening again. But the approach has, in some cases, made the situation even worse. Hundreds of thousands of people have found themselves trapped in flats with cladding that might be a fire risk, unable to feel safe and unable to sell and move on. Some are being told that they themselves will have to foot huge bills to replace the cladding. And bizarrely, even people living in flats that are not affected are being told their property is now unmortgageable because they can't prove their building is safe. The scale of the scandal is huge and multifaceted. A programme to inspect cladding is taking place across the country, but at a much slower rate than people living in these flats ever could possibly have imagined. There are around 3,000 apartment blocks that need inspecting, and there just aren't enough specialist inspectors qualified to do the job. Flats in high-rise buildings are usually leasehold. If the cladding fails the inspection and needs removing, the cost will likely fall to the leaseholder, not the freeholder, even though the cladding was not put up at the request of the homeowners or leaseholders. Nevertheless, they are the ones apparently having to foot a potentially huge bill because their property is unsafe to live in. The government did announce a £1 billion building safety fund to pay for removing unsafe cladding, but the government itself has said the cost of this will be around £3.5 billion. This means the fund falls way short and many homeowners will be forced to pay. In fact, the funding only covers the 1,700 most at-risk buildings and not the further 9,500 that potentially have dangerous cladding. Many affected homeowners purchased their properties under the shared ownership scheme, designed to help people who struggle most to buy a home. It's a particularly bitter pill to swallow for this group, who are being told now that they're responsible for 100% of the cost, while they own only a small percentage of their property. Doesn't make a lot of sense to me. Of course, the burden isn't just a financial one. Unsurprisingly, the threat of living in a potential inferno is taking an enormous toll. There have been reports of a mental health crisis for people living in buildings they fear could be the next Grenfell Tower. Some have resorted to walking watches, where people walk around a block of flats all day and all night, ready to sound the fire alarm. But the cost of this also sits with the leaseholders. Now, there's a further cladding scandal affecting millions of flat owners. Since the disastrous fire, the construction industry, surveyors, management companies and lenders all worked together to produce something called an external wall survey, known as an EWS1. This form was designed for buildings over 18 metres, that's about 5 stories high, to prove that a suitable expert has checked that the block hasn't been built with flammable materials. The intention when EWS1 was launched late last year was to provide assurance that a building was safe, or to indicate what remedial work was needed, so that thousands of stalled property transactions could then go ahead. Unfortunately, this survey is causing unexpected mortgage complications. There are apparently less than 300 fire engineers in the country qualified to perform these inspections. So where lenders insist on an EWS1, it's leading to massive delays. Which buildings need an EWS1 vary from lender to lender. Some lenders are demanding the form for buildings that don't even have any cladding. It's led to massive frustration for hopeful home buyers and many leaseholders who are unable to sell or even remortgage their homes. The government tightened safety advice in January, which means that lenders are now requiring evidence that any modern built flat, even a 3-story building, is safe. Not evidence that it's unsafe, evidence that it's safe. But it'll take years to inspect all the buildings, and many more years on top of that to sort out the ones that are affected. The result has been widespread outrage. Roughly 3 million people are effectively trapped, with as much as 6% of all the homes in Britain being deemed unmortgageable. because sellers have no way of proving their building is safe. The government has to take action. A fair system needs to be put in place and current rules reviewed. Thankfully, not every high-rise block is as dangerous as Grenfell Tower was, but the system for assessing the safety of buildings does not seem to reflect this. So today, I'm asking you to join us in petitioning the government to help thousands of homeowners living in fear for their safety and unfairly penalised financially. Please join the hashtag #EndOurCladdingScandal group on Twitter and sign the petition to the government to take action. There are links to both of these below, and if we keep the pressure up, then we can and we will make a difference. Thank you very much.